Are you looking to create disposable WordPress sites? Well, that is possible with InstaWP. And before you even ask yourself, why would I actually need to create disposable websites? Well, there's several reasons why you might want to do this. And one of the most important ones is that you are probably a developer and you need to test your plugins, your themes, and you need to make sure that they actually work in each individual PHP version, in the version of WordPress, and a lot of other things. And if you are a common guy just like me using WordPress, well, also you want to do some testing, make sure that the sites are working with the amount of WordPress plugins that you're using, the theme, that they actually connect one with another and you don't have issues with it, or maybe you're just doing testing with them. In my case, I can use this for making videos and I don't need to install a whole WordPress site on my own server. I can use InstaWP. And yes, there is a great free plan that is usable. So let's go jump over to my desktop to show you what I'm talking about right now. What's up everyone, my name is George and this is SaaS Master. This is the InstaWP site, and if you guys want to check it out, that link will be provided in the description. Like I mentioned before, there's several reasons why you might want to check out InstaWP. Now let me show you really quickly the pricing plans, because like I mentioned before, they have a free plan that's practically really good, right? You can use this. And with the free plan, you can actually have active 5 sites. The expiration date for those type of sites is 2 days. What does that mean? That in 48 hours, that site is going to be removed and you can create a new one. That's on the free plan. And if you jump into free, paid versions, I mean, well, you get more active sites, you get more expiration time. So that means that you can do some further testing because you have more days. And there's also a really neat feature on the paid plan. You can actually reserve a site. That means that it won't expire. So it's pretty cool because that way you can do constant testing with that site that you created, that disposable site. You can restore sites depending on the time. For example, free plan, you get 3. And there's several things that you don't get with the free plan, but like I mentioned before, it's really usable. Okay, and there's more advanced features like FTP, custom domain, SSH access, disk storage, you get more advanced configurations, team, so on and so forth, that you do get with paid plans and some with the free. So for example, templates, I can only create one with the free plan. What does a template mean? Well, I can have a set of plugins, themes, or whatever, and I can convert that into a theme. So I don't have to manually tick with the settings every single time. You get template sites, 5, 15 with paid, 25 and 50, so on and so forth. Advanced options, template branding, Insta templates, coming soon cloning, and basically that's it. You kind of get the idea that you can use the free plan for your testing without any issues. You only get, well, less sites and the time frame is smaller and you can't reserve site. Those are the things that I would consider important for the paid plans. Okay, now into my InstaWP dashboard. Now I already created a site, but I will create one from scratch right now just to show you how easy this is, all right? So without further ado, I'll click a new site. I can choose the WordPress version. The latest one is 5.9 as of today. The PHP version, I can go all the way up to 8.1, which is pretty new, okay? So it's pretty good that we have this for testing. So I'll go with 8.0, for example. Choose configuration, I'll go with default. I haven't created a different configuration. And the site name, I'll just say test. Okay, I'll create the site, install it in progress. I'm not speeding this up. We're actually gonna wait for this to create. Okay, it's creating database. Let's give it a few more seconds. And I'll show you in a bit another things that you can do with it. Applying configurations. There we go. It's been created and I have it right here. So in my case, I'm on the paid plan. So it jumps to 7 days. And you can see right here, my WP version, my PHP, the disk usage for this, I'll refresh it. Oh, by the way, here are my credentials to log in. I can either do this manually, go and log in, or I can do it from here. I'm actually going to get a test also with this configuration, so I have that information later on. I'll refresh it. There we go, it hasn't updated the disk storage. Okay, what if I wanna go check out the site? Well, I can go here really quickly. And here it is, here's the installation. And another thing that I've noticed, just heads up, it's really snappy, it's actually pretty fast. If I wanna go directly to log in, that means I can jump the admin area so I don't have to type in my admin and username. I can go straight from here, okay? Now, this is my WordPress installation. It's a clean installation. There's no bloatware, there's no like freemium plugins or anything like that. Even on the free version, you won't get that things installed, okay? So this is my WordPress plugin. I can go ahead and start my testing. I can do plugins, I can install them. I can change the theme. I'll change, for example, the theme right there. There's these versions. I can go ahead and update it. Go there. I can change different themes that are installed for WordPress. I can do things like, I don't know, go into settings, general. I'll go into themes right here. I already activated one. My bad. I'll switch it. I'll customize it. Here's a customization. Like I mentioned before, it's pretty snappy because the back end of WordPress, I mean, I've tested on other sites. I have a bunch of WordPress sites. It's not as snappy as this, okay? So I can go ahead and change my colors here and all of that. It's super easy to start testing with WordPress. It's super fast, right? Next thing we can do is we can check out the database if I want to open it. There's a lot of advanced settings. So here's a database. I can work with the database. I can manipulate this database so I can do my testing without any issues. I can check out the information for the error log, if there's any, the access log for this. Okay, I can jump into the code editor. Now, this I haven't seen on other similar type of sites that let you create disposable WordPress sites. Now, here I'm on the editor and I can actually edit. So if I go into this file, let me click on it. Oh, my bad, didn't want to do that. There it is. Okay, I've opened this Hello.php. And I can go ahead and edit the PHP file from here. And I can view the changes. And there's also a little bug, so I can find errors right here. So no errors found. But if I start going crazy with this, let's go check if there's any errors. No new errors yet. But yes, we can edit this and it will go live and we can see. So for example, in my case, if you have a really important WordPress site that you are using, I would actually redo everything here. So when I'm doing testing and manipulating files and all of that, I do it from over here. And everything goes fine, then I go do it on the live site. It's just an example of what you can do, okay? So that's the code editor, and there's more options here on the dropdown. I can view credentials just in case I forget what the login page is, what the username and the password for this one is. So I can view them from there. It's pretty cool. Export as local WP. So in case you want to export this and use it, I can go ahead and delete this website. I have no access to advanced options on this account. Access FTP SSH login credentials. I do need to have the SSH data enabled on the options, on the settings, and I can have access to this. So via FTP, I can go actually access this website and again, manipulate it if I need to. I can map the domain to another domain. I just have to point it with this a record, okay? Pretty cool, right? You can save this as a template. So like I mentioned before, if you're manipulating this, you've added a couple of plugins and you change the theme, and basically that's what you're doing every single time, so it becomes a habit. Well, instead of doing it every single time and loading every single time, the theme, the plugins, the settings and all that, well, you can save it as a template, which is pretty useful. And I can reserve this site. Again, that means that it won't be deleted at the time of expire. So for example, this will expire 7 days. If I reserve it like this one, it's locked, okay? That means it's not going to be deleted. So a lot of things that you can do with this instances of WordPress. I can go check out the templates. So in this case, I already saved one template. Status is ready and it was created 5 days ago. I can go ahead and edit it. I can do a plus sign, I can create a new site, and I can go ahead and delete it. There's also configuration that saves you time. So instead of every single time doing some changes, so for example, right now by default, it's using WordPress version 5.9, sorry, and PHP version 7.4. If I'm actually working already in 8.0, or I'm doing tests for my plugin or my theme in 8.1, well, let's use that as default. That's really good and time saver. I can save as new if I want to create another one, and I'll have those drop down options when I create a new website. In this case, I'll keep it like that. Let's go ahead and save it. And when I create a new WordPress site, it will have this options. There's also PHP settings, more advanced settings right here. So max execution time and so on and so forth for PHP. For WordPress, again, we have these options available. Automatic update is disabled. I can remove this so it does update. WP debug, WP update core, multi-site installation, pre-installed plugins. If I want to add some, I can search for the slug on wp.org and add those there. Pre-installed themes also, URL for theme or plugins, theme or plugin, and add it. So all of those configurations could be done previously, so you have those ready. And there's also integrations for this. There's a Chrome extension and a Slack installation. So for example, for Slack, inside of the Slack chat, you can actually create an instance of WordPress, so a disposable website right there, and you'll get the credentials. So if you have teammates there that are working, it's super fast and super quick to create this. That's pretty cool, right? So that is InstaWP. If you guys want to check it out, that link will be provided in the description. I thank y'all for watching. My name's George, and I'll see you guys later.